We're doing eyewash two. I got Dave helping me out here. He's going to do Sunny, and then I'm going to do Mr. T. And Buddy's out roaming around, so I'm not going to do him. So what we did is I gave Dave one of these little, I showed you in one, the little packets you can get. He lost it with all his money in his pocket. So one of those will do, show me the little thing there, Dave. One of those will do a horse's eye on both sides, because he's going to put a couple drops in each eye. Now, we didn't do anything here before. He hasn't done anything. We haven't practiced, so we're just going to do it as we go. So you see what you get. There's a couple ways to do it. I'm going to do it one way on Mr. T. He's going to do it his way on this guy. So this is horse Sonny. He's just going to put a little eye lubricant in there. Now, this horse had an eye cut for a while, so he was used to getting antibiotic. And your horse is going to pull like that. Sometimes I need to tie them up and make them where they can't pull, especially with Buddy, because he'll pull. But what I like to do is kind of let him see it. He's got a rope halter there. He's just going to pull the eye down. Sonny's going to give him a hard time. You did? Right there in the corner. Squirt in there. Then they'll blink, and then he rubs it out. And it looks like there's some already in there, so we're going to go around the other eye here. And, of course, I'm sticking a camera in the horse's face, and Buddy's running around causing problems. So, and we're in the shade, so somebody's going to complain that they couldn't
see it.
Come here, bud. Just going to put my hand over here, help a little bit. He's just going to roll the pocket down again. I don't know if he got any in there or not.
I'll pick that one in.
Easy, bud.
Come on, son.
It's okay.
Come on.
He's just
a knucklehead.
He's kind of a...
Come on.
Again, I wouldn't recommend holding a horse the way I got my hand here, because that's a good way to get your hand caught if he pulls.
Son, stop.
Nobody can see.
Here, we got it.
You got it in there? Okay.
Yeah. Look it out, buddy.
Now, I want to show you, he did the little eye drop, and I'll do that on one side of Mr. T, and then I'm going to do a plunger, which is in case I wanted to wash it out. See, now he's being better because I'm not over with the camera. You got any more left for the other eye? Go back to the other eye and see if you get a little more in.
Yeah. Damn little hole in that thing.
Yeah.
So your hole would be easier. Yeah.
And then they'll blink. And again, this just helps wash out the eye, gets irritants, pollutants, pollen, dust.
I haven't done this in him in years.
Yeah, and you're going to have these problems, which is why we didn't want to practice and do this, because you're going to have to be able to hold your horse and get them to let you do it. It's odd. It's not, the horse wasn't being bad. Dave, you want to take this camera there? And what I'm going to show you is, hopefully you can see here. Can you get good light there?
It's coming through pretty nice.
This is just a little plunger and a little, the Bosch and Lomb that I showed you in one. And what I do is I pull this plunger out, and then I put my finger over the cap so it doesn't loop, doesn't drip out. Squirt some in there. Then I put my plunger back in while my finger's still on it before I turn upside down so I don't squirt it out. Turn it upside down, and now I squirt this air out. And now I'm just going to be able to squirt this in his eye a little bit. Now the thing you want to be careful about when you're doing this is if you squirt it right in the eye, this makes a hard stream, so it's going to hurt. So I try to do it in a corner, so we're going to go over here to Mr. T.
Now we're... Let's see if we can get this. Oh, there we go. That's good.
And then, again, because this is odd, if you go straight for the eye, you never want to go straight for the end result with a horse. You always want to go make the horse don't think that I'm going for this eye. So I'm going to let him see this. I'm going to scratch his eye like I normally do. I'm going to get him used to this thing in my hand so he knows, so I don't just go right up here and try to squirt in his eye because he sees this foreign object. So, again, Mr. T's pretty good. He's not going to tell me no. He's going to blink his eye. So I can do it one of two ways. I can shoot from the rear and shoot at any eye right here, and he'll blink a little bit, and he doesn't see it coming. And that's one way to get it in. Again, there's a little eye wash in there. So now I'm going to blink, and I'm going to help him rub it. And if there's any dirt, I rub from the back forward to force any stuff to come out this eye here. And I don't see anything coming out, so he doesn't have anything there. The other way to do this is if you have the little thing, is I like to roll this little pocket right here. You see this little opening right here on his eye? And I squirt it right in there. And then it goes in the eye. And Mr. T will blink. And again, I don't want to go straight for that eye, and I don't want to squirt a stream straight in the eye, because then you get a horse rearing and pulling back, and it hurts him. no sooner than you want something in your eye. So again, you can either go from the back. If I wanted to go up top and score at the top of the eye, I could put it here, see how he wants to blink because he knows what's coming. And then I just score it a little bit. When his eye's open, I just wait. Score it a little bit in there. We'll go to the other side. Good boy, Mr. T.
Yeah, better view.
Better view?
Yeah, light. Yeah, okay. I started to be, but no. Weird. I wish there was a way to adjust the lighting, but they can see it.
So, again, what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a little pocket right here, and I'm going to score it right now, a little pocket. And you saw him flinch, and I know I got it in there, and now he blinks his eye, and I rub him. This is all about getting your horse used to it. Again, if I want to come from the rear and squirt it forward in the eye, you really can't see it. I'm in his blind spot. You're going to see me squirt here. And it went in the eye that way. And now he blunked and it's in there. So there's a couple different ways to get in there. This is using syringe. Dave showed you on how to use the little dropper. I could do the same thing with the dropper. I like doing the little pocket right here with the dropper and I just put a little drop in there. You don't want to get this close and try to shove it in the eye because if the horse moves into it when he's wiggling, you'll stab him. So I want to keep this in an area, and again, I'm desensitizing. I'm sacking out right now. I'm letting him know that things can touch his eye. It's natural for him to flinch. So I'm going to get this close as I can, either going this way or coming in this way so I don't puncture the eye. I don't want to come straight in and end up having a horse move. Now, if I had to flush it and there was something in there that was hurting him and I had a full syringe, maybe I would come here and go straight in the eye and squirt it in there to get a good flush. But I don't want to make it, because that's going to hurt him and it's going to put pressure on his eye. So I want to come at this angle, either here, here, maybe straight up here, or do the little pocket and come down. Okay, that's the eyewash tube, putting eyewash in your horse's eye. Dave, you remember how to turn that off?
Yep. Bye.
We're done.